Hey everyone, it's Monica. So I'm finally back to share some of the reveal videos for my loaded envelope slash pocket swap. Now, before I get started, very quickly, I want to say thank you to everybody who participated, who got their swaps in on time, and did a fabulous job. Thank you so much. Now, with that being said, we did have some mishaps, had a flaker, had some people back out. So we did have a couple of angels. I angeled for, I believe it's group six. The participant had some issues that came up and notified me early enough. So I angeled for group six. Also had an issue with, what group was it? I think it's group three. I'm not sure. But I had someone else angel for that group. Last minute, I did have a flaker, so I will be having to angel for that one. That is actually group three, the person who has flaked. I have gone ahead and banned this person, but I will have to angel. Now, please bear in mind, there will be a delay in it. I have a very, very busy schedule, hence also before I get into it. If you haven't been a part of my swaps, the turnaround on my swaps is a bit longer than the average swap. I work full-time. I work a regular 40-hour week in the office, and I often have to work on the weekends from home. So I typically do a 50 to 60-hour work week. So my crafting time is very limited. I craft on the weekends when I have time. I don't have time to craft on the weekdays because I have two young children who need my help with school. There's after-school activities. There's all the things that I need to do. Crafting just does not come into play. So I ask that you please be patient. I will try to roll out group three as quickly as I possibly can. But yeah, just know that there will be a delay and I will be the one angeling for that person. So very quickly, while I do not mind if you email me or message me asking me the status of the swap, I have no problem with an email. But I will say that there have been a few people who have emailed me like three or four times already. That's a little excessive, especially when it's only been a week since the postmark date. Because trust me, I have had a few people who have sent me numerous emails and it's only been 1 week since the postmark date. Please allow time. I'm not a person who doesn't work. I'm not a person who's always home. I do have a very busy life. I will get to it as quickly as possible. If this is a problem for you, please don't participate in my swaps. With that being said, if you are late, if you flake, if you back out after the certain date, I will ban you permanently from my swap. I do not give second chances. I might occasionally do a newbie redeem group where if you're new or if you've been late before, I might give you a second chance, but I will let you know in that swap. But just be aware, if you are late or if you back out after the deadline that I give, I will ban you from my swaps, especially for reasons like this, because you have flakers. I don't have the time to constantly angel. So I'm very strict with my swaps. Again, turnaround time is not quickly, so please be patient. Otherwise, please join a swap with another hostess or another group. My swaps will not be the ones for you. Okay, with that being said, very quickly, I show the reveal videos once I have the packages ready to mail. So if you're watching this video, I either have already mailed your swap back to you or I'm sending it out the day this releases. Either way, it is going out as soon as you see this video live. So you will not be seeing these daily. I'm trying to do them every other day. It just depends on how I can get everything ready and out the door and if I film the reveal videos. Trust me, I'm trying to get these out as quickly as possible. Okay, so I think that is about it. Oh, one more thing about the swaps. Please be sure that if you are swapping with me, before you mail out your swap to me, please make sure that you rewatch the swap video and make sure you fulfilled all of the requirements. I know sometimes you can overlook things, you can forget about it. So please be sure to look at the video before you send it out to me. That way you're not missing anything from your swap. There have been a few where some have missed putting the sweet treat into the swap. So I've gone in and filled in and just thrown the sweet treat that I added for my personal packages. I've added it for the ones who've missed it. I did have to remove someone from the group because they didn't fulfill the requirement as I had listed them, and they noticed it a little bit too late after they mailed their package, and they were not able to fulfill the rest of it after they had already mailed it out. So I did go ahead and remove them from the group. But so just be very careful and be very aware. Watch the video again and make sure that you fulfill every requirement from the swap before you mail it out to me. Okay, I'm gonna quit rambling. This is a really long intro already. So again, thank you everybody who participated. And I'm gonna go ahead and get started and start showing off all the ladies in the group. As always, if the ladies in your group did film a YouTube video, I will list their channel and direct link the video to their swap in the description box below. If they have an Instagram, I will go ahead and list their Instagram handle. That way you can go ahead and check them out. Please be sure to head over to all of the ladies' channels and show them support. They've all done a wonderful job. This was a very time-consuming and very labor-intensive swap, so please be sure to show them some love. Alrighty, I'm going to quit rambling and I will get into the first lady of the group. Okay, so up first for group number one, we have Shantae, who is simply Shantae here on YouTube. Shantae did create a video of her swap, so I will go ahead and link her channel. I'll actually be direct linking her video for the swap in the description box below. One of the participants is an Instagram user, so I will go ahead and just put her Instagram handle in the description box below, and you can go ahead and check out her channel. Okay, so here is how her swap comes packaged. She has a nice simple white loaded envelope with some detailed decorative fabric and a nice little paper flower here in the center. Here is a close-up of how hers comes packaged. Right here you have Shantae, YouTube, simply Shantae, and she's in group number one. So let me go ahead and get these others out of the way. She did create one for me, so thank you. So I will be opening it up on video and showing you the contents. Again, if you're not familiar, if the group member did not create one for me, that is perfectly okay, but just be aware that I will not be showing it. I will show the package as I show it here. If they do have a YouTube channel and a video, that'll be linked in the description box below, which I will also mention, but I will not open somebody else's package regardless of how it's packaged, even if I can access to it. I can access it, like for example, with this one, it has the separate flap, so I can easily open it and show you. But if it's not one for the hostess, for me, I will not open it. Those will be untouched. I will send them to the recipients of the group. You'll go ahead, if the creator did create a video, just check out their link in the description box below. But I will notify you if that is the case. Okay, so let me go ahead and get these out of the way, and I'll be right back. Okay, so here we have Shantae's package. As you can see, she has a dimensional envelope that she created, I'm assuming with her envelope punch board. She does have, this looks like a half inch gusset, so she can go ahead and stuff it. This is how her swap comes packaged, so let's go ahead and get the items out. I did remove the outside bag prior to starting the video to avoid a lot of the crinkling. So let's go ahead and get everything out. Again, like I said, Shantae does have a video showing all of these items. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. One of the requirements was to add a simple sweet treat to the swap for your participants. Now, I do know some of the other participants did give larger treats, which is perfectly okay. But in case those of you who are wondering, it is something small and simple that I was requesting. I always, you know, be mindful of shipping, because shipping does get expensive and those larger candies are expensive. But in case you were wondering, thinking that you had to give something big, you do not. This is a perfect example of what I was talking about. A nice, small, fun size sweet treat. So here's her sweet treat. The easiest one we'll go ahead and take a look at is her dimensional flower she had Create Crate for. She did create, I think she used a Cricut file for this particular flower. It's been a while since I watched her video. Again, it'll be linked in the description box below. She tells you how she goes over and how she created all of these items. I do know she used Cricut files to go ahead and create all of these things for you. So here's the flowers. Next, let's go ahead and do the sentiments. And I believe she did two of the same. So she did two of each. And the requirements for the sentiments, they had to be dimensional. They had to have layers, I should say, not dimensional. As you can see, she has a couple of different layers to both sentiments. They had to have a sentiment and a blank factor. Her blank factor are the gems that she has on here. So she did two of the thanks. These say thanks big time. They're stamped in black ink. She's got a gold foil layer here, backed on a white scallop. And then she has that scalloped popped up on dimensionals on the back piece, the back black piece that she has. So there's the first sentiment. So she has two of those. Next, she has this one that says to my special someone. Again, this has a couple of layers. She's got the green foil. She's got the stamping and the gems. Then she's got the white layer where it has a stamp sentiment, which is popped up on dimensionals on top of the black base. And she has two of these as well. So here are her four sentiments. Next, we have the 4x4 note cards that you had to create. And I apologize for the crinkling. So here are the four envelopes to go with her note cards. And here is note card number one. It says, "Happy Everything." It does have the required sentiment, and she has a couple of different layers used foil. She has white, and it is on a black card base. You open it up, just simple matting for the whoever is giving this out can write a message to the recipient. So here's the first one, says happy everything. The second one says hi there. It has a teacup or a coffee cup. Shantae loves coffee and tea, so it's fitting that she went ahead and she added this. She has the coffee cup popped up on dimensionals with her sentiment that says hi there. And then she has this beautiful intricate die cut in the background, and she has gems. She's also using the gold foil as an accent, and it is also on a black card base. And it looks like she created two of the coffee cup and two of the happy everything. So there are her four note cards that she created. And last but not least, we have the four additional embellishments that you were required to make. These were your choice. It didn't matter. It was entirely up to you. So we have two of these circle scallops with a coffee or teacup with a little heart in the center. That cup is popped up on dimensionals. Everything has multiple layers, so it is super sturdy. So you have two of those. She's got green foil cardstock on here, as well as the gold. And the other two are these nice, simple, square scalloped butterfly embellishments. The butterflies are also dimensional. They are popped up. You got the two different layers with the white scallop and well as the black base. And we have the two gems in the corner. So here are the four embellishments for the swap. And let me go ahead and lay everything out here so you can just take a quick peeky overview at Shantae's swap. Again, her video will be linked in the description box below. Go ahead and check out her video in case you're interested in any of the products that I used, that she used. I know she used a lot of Cricut files for her note cards and embellishments and sentiments, and I believe also for the flowers. So go ahead and check it out in case you're interested, and go ahead and show her some love. Alrighty, let's move on to the second member of the group. Okay, up next we have Alexandra, who is Apollonia 1017 on Instagram. She does not do YouTube. She is an Instagram crafter, so her Instagram handle will be linked in the description box below. So please go to Instagram, check her out, give her some love. She is a return swapper on my channel. I believe this is her second swap with me. She did create one for me, so I can go ahead and open it up and show it to you. But this is how her swap comes packaged. The paper in mine is a little bit different than it is on everybody else's. She did go ahead and tag my name on here. For her swap partners, she did go ahead and do a glittered for you. She did not personalize them, just mine. So let me go ahead and get these out of the way. I will go ahead and open up mine and show you what's inside. Okay, so we are back with Alexandra's swap. So she went ahead and created, looks like she created her own custom tag and added a nice chunky pocket to the tag. Here is how she has it decorated. She has a nice little flower, some leaves, a little leaf sprig, and she has a just for you sentiment with some rhinestones here on the front. As requested, I didn't want you guys to mark anything on the loaded envelope, tag, pocket, whatever it was that you were creating to house your swap, because I did want the recipients to be able to reuse this if they wished. So to personalize mine, she went ahead and attached this banner with my name, Monica, to the ribbon at the top of the tag. So let's go ahead and take out the contents. So let's go ahead and start off with the sentiments, since they are in the front. She has these little package sentiments. Both of them say thanks. They are done out of red and blue. This is a blue glitter cardstock. The thanks is embossed in gold embossing powder, and the thanks is popped up on dimensionals on top of this decorative flourishy tag that she has there. So both of them are exactly the same, just different colors. This one is on glitter cardstock, and this is on regular matte cardstock. The other two are on the back, so you have four. So she created four thanks sentiments for me. So let's go ahead. I was gonna take it back and leave it. Here we have her four dimensional flowers. She gave me two different colors. She has this, it's not quite mustardy yellow, it's more of a, these are definitely fall colors, which I definitely love. So she's got a couple of different layers to each flower. She has my favorite flower metal stamens that I always use. She's gone ahead and attached leaves to each of the flowers for you. And here we have kind of this terracotta, deep orange, burnt orange type of color here. So here are her four dimensional flowers. Next, we have the four miscellaneous embellishments of your choice. So she created four bows, and they are all done out of gold cardstock. You have two out of gold glitter, and this is like a gold metallic foil. It's definitely got an imprint. It's textured. It's a textured bow, or cardstock, I should say. So here are her four embellishments, and I'm sorry for the glare, but I don't want to sit here and take up too much time trying to open up each package. And last but not least, we have her note cards. And I do know that she posted pictures on her Instagram in case you wanted to see them a little bit closer. So each one has its four envelopes. So this first one here, you've got the thank you friend. This is popped up on dimensionals behind a banner, and she has a simple little card here. You open it up, and she did go ahead and she also added a sentiment on the inside. So here's number one. Number two just says thank you. Same type of style. It looks like she might have used the same paper collection or coordinating papers, but they are all the same tone. Again, this one also has a stamp sentiment inside. And like I mentioned in my video when I first did the swap, they don't have to be fancy or over the top. They can be simple, just make them look beautiful. So here is another one. Also says you're the best. And the fourth one has thank you, thank you, another dimensional flower, and the same sentiment from the bottom of my heart. So here are her 4x4 note cards. Again, this is Alexandra on Instagram. Instagram handle is Apollonia1017, if I am correct. I'll double check it and I'll make sure that I have the right link in the description box below. But here's Alexandra's project. Please go ahead and check out her Instagram and show her some love. And on to the next participant in the group. Alrighty, last but definitely not least, we have Polite Creations. I am so sorry, but I am completely drawing a blank on your first name right now. I have been watching her channel to get familiar with her, and I just completely blanked out, so I'm so sorry. She does have a YouTube video on her swap. I will link that in the description box below. She goes over how she did everything in a swap. I believe she also did a separate video to do a tutorial, if I recall. I know I saw a video on just the flowers on their own. I do believe she did a tutorial, or she tells you how she created them. So go ahead and check out her channel if you're interested on how she created the flowers. I'm not linking the video to the flowers. You'll have to check out her channel for that, but I will go ahead and list the package itself. Hold on 1 second. My little one just walked into the room. Okay, the little one wanted something, so I had to go get it for him. Okay, so let me go ahead and get these out of the way. I will go ahead and open up the outside packaging, that way you don't have to hear the crinkling. But she did go ahead and personalize each one with a nice little tag that she attached to a ribbon around the whole package. So I will be right back in just a second. Alrighty, here is how her swap comes packaged. All of the packages do have this tag with ribbon tied around it. It has your name, the group, and then it has her little Polite Creations. It has her YouTube and Instagram on it, which is both Polite Creations. So each one of you will receive one of these. And here is how her swap comes packaged. She created an acetate envelope, and I believe she lined it with decorative paper as well. But she created it with acetate to give it more stability. She has this big, beautiful die cut piece here on the outside, on the front. And I believe she says she used Nouveau drops all around here. So let's go ahead and take everything out. So inside, here is her sweet treat that she has given. She has given a nice big box of Mike and Ike's. And we will start off with her flowers. Here are her four-dimensional flowers. I believe she created these out of vellum. Again, it's been a while since I watched your video, my apologies. So go ahead and check out her channel for all of the details. So here is how her flowers come packaged. Next, we have the sentiments. So here we have a hello there, a wishing you joy. She used pearls here as her bling element. For the top one, she has the star. It looks like she went ahead and used the coordinating cardstock from the paper stack that she used. And on the back, we have a This Is Me Missing You and a Happy Birthday. So here are her four sentiments. Here we have her four additional embellishments. She created all of these four bows. Looks like she used the decorative paper as well and some vellum, as well as some chunky glitter throughout the bows. So here is the embellishments. And last but not least, we have her note cards. So let's go ahead and open these up. And I apologize for the crinkling. Okay. So card number one, we have this one here. It's stamped and embossed in white. It says one of a kind. Has a white mat on the inside. And it comes with a black envelope. We have two black envelopes for each card. And this one is also says one of a kind. This one is on a darker background. Here we go. The other two. Oop, more crinkling. We have a thank you here. Again, simple but beautiful and elegant. And another thank you on a different pattern paper background. So here are her four note cards. Now this, go ahead and finish this up. The group number one. Again, please go ahead and check out all of the ladies' channels or Instagram. All of the information will be in the description box below. As a quick reminder, in case you skip through the beginning, I will be doing these in sequence. I will not be posting a video every single day. I will post them as soon as I can get your package out to the post office. Please be patient. And again, there will be a delay in group number three since I will be having to angel for it. So I do apologize for the delay in that one. And I hope you guys stay tuned and watch out for the next group. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!